Welcome back. This is part two of the lesson on integration by parts. Let's move on to problem two, the integral of x squared times e to the power of x with respect to x. Step one, identify function type. I see I'm working with the product of two integrals. I don't see a relationship for which I can apply substitution, so I'm going to use integration by parts. Step two, apply integration rule. I'll identify my u, and I'll identify my dv terms. First, the u, looking at the list of Lipet functions. There aren't any logarithmic functions. There aren't any inverse trig functions. There is a polynomial, x squared, so I'll assign x squared to u. Du over dx is 2x, and to isolate du, I'll multiply both sides by dx. Du is 2x with respect to x. The remaining function, e to the power of x, is dv over dx. To isolate dv, I'll multiply both sides by dx. Dv is e to the power of x with respect to x. Integrating to get to v, the integral of e to the power of x is e to the power of x. Now I will set up my integration by parts equation. The integral of u times dv. In our case, u is x squared, and dv is e to the power of x dx equals u times v, here, x squared times e to the power of x, minus the integral of v du. V is e to the power of x, du is 2x dx. Before we complete the integration, I'm going to go up at the beginning of step two and add in arrows to emphasize that we start with the u term and we differentiate to the du term. In the case of v, we start with the dv term and integrate to the v term. Continuing on with our integration, looking at the right-hand side of the equation, equals x squared times e to the power of x minus the integral of e to the power of x times 2x with respect to x. Now notice what we have in this integral is another product of two functions. The difference in this case is we've simplified one of those functions. We still have e to the power of x, but x squared is now 2x. We've decreased the degree of the polynomial function from 2 to 1. We're going to do another round of integration by parts, and then we'll decrease that degree from 1 to 0, and then we'll have a constant and only one function that we're integrating. So again, looking for a u, working our way down the Lipet list, we have no log function, no inverse trig function. We do have a polynomial function, 2x. Du over dx is 2. And multiplying by dx, we have du equals 2 dx. The remaining function is e to the power of x. So dv over dx equals e to the power of x. Isolating dv, we have e to the power of x with respect to x, and integrating e to the power of x to get our v term, we also have e to the power of x. From u, differentiating to du, from dv, integrating to v. And now we have x squared times e to the power of x minus our second integration by parts, uv minus the integral of v du. Here u is 2x, v is e to the power of x, minus the integral of v is e to the power of x, and du is 2 dx. And now the integral we're working with is e to the power of x times not a function, but a constant, the integral of 2 e to the power of x. Further simplifying equals x squared times e to the power of x minus 2xe to the power of x minus minus, distributing the negative, gives us a plus the integral of 2 times e to the power of x, which is plus 2 times the integral of e to the power of x with respect to x, that is e to the power of x. Here we'll add our constant of integration plus c, and we've completed our integration. The integral of x squared times e to the power of x with respect to x is x squared e to the power of x minus 2x e to the power of x plus 2 e to the power of x plus c. We've completed all requirements, and this concludes the lesson on integration by parts.